Okay, so let me take another question. So I was all the way back there, over here in the Abraham Lincoln assassination area. The Ford's Theater section. Okay, can you like them any better? Because it's very hard for me to pick somebody out of this waving mass of humanity here. Okay, right there on the corner. Did he get it? Oh, cool, look at that. Okay, good technique, man.
On? Okay. There's a lot of wonderful people here to see you tonight, and I know you said you write one part of the music before you do the other. Could you maybe write a little something for your audience this evening? Sing a little bit? One for us?
Probably not. You know,
just thought I'd ask.
Okay. You don't understand. I can't write in front of all these people. I mean, I gotta like be alone. I'm usually like in a bathrobe and like grungy and walking around the house kicking things. You don't want to be around me when I'm writing. Trust me, I get grouchy and cranky and I'm in a lousy mood. Until I get it, what, somebody claps, they know this firsthand. And another thing, to be honest, I don't write thinking about an audience. I can't second guess what it is you would like to hear. I can't write thinking about, what do my fans want to hear next? You know, and I don't even like the word fans, because it makes you all like this nameless, faceless blob of fandom, you know? You know, yeah, I'm assuming you're all individual people, and if you like what I do, you must have, you know, your own individual intellect, you know? So I don't think about an audience. I can't think about an audience. If I start to think about,
7 million people bought the last album, so I'll direct this next album towards those same 7 million people.
I don't do that. Who can do that? Or I don't write for radio. Who the hell knows what they're going to play on the radio? I don't write for the record company. I don't write for critics. I don't write for, you know, whoever. I write for me. It's purely for my own silly enjoyment. But it's whatever moves me. But let me give you some insight into how I do write, okay? I'm going to play something on this synthesizer. It's not an orchestra. It's not a string section. And it's not going to be exactly how it's supposed to sound. I'll give you an example. I realized I've always been trying to write like the composers I always admired. I was driving along in my car. I was living in Huntington at the time. I was driving on Route 110, which can be a pain in the ass to drive on. And it was like around, it was in the springtime, it was around Easter time, which is one of those holy times of year, you know? So it's raining, and the sky is cloudy, and really gloomy, and I'm driving in my car, and I hear this music, and it goes like this.
Thank you.
This is a piece of music called the Adagio for Strings. It's one of the saddest pieces of music ever written. It was written by a composer named Samuel Barber. It's so sad, they played it the night that Franklin Delano Roosevelt died. Now, I had heard this music before, but I never listened, really tuned into it. So I'm driving, I'm sitting on 110. What else am I going to do except tune into the radio, because the bastard in front of me is going about 5 miles an hour, right? Now, they used this piece of music in The Elephant Man, the movie The Elephant Man, and in Platoon. They used it because it's so sad. Da-na-na-na-na, and it builds and it builds and it builds. And I'm shortcutting and not playing it right. And it ends on this. It doesn't end. It builds to this peak. And as it gets to that peak, the sun shoots out of the clouds and it stops raining, and I get to, like, I cross over 25A and the traffic clears up. I had to pull over. Right? And I pull over to the side of the road and I burst out crying. And I said, "What's happening to me?" I lost control. I just lost it. What happened? And I realized that this is what I love about music. This is what I want to do. This is what I want to create. This is what I've always tried to create. And if you get a chance to go to a store and find this piece of music, you may not be classical music fans, but if you ever really just want to get yourself totally bummed out, and you like, you know, because sometimes it's okay. Get the Adagio for Strings, and that's the kind of thing that I want to write, and I hope before I can't write anymore that I create music like that. So that's as close as I'm going to be able to explain it to you. Okay.